हाय हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड इवनिंग। आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अल्कोहल्स इन दिस क्लास। ओके, क्लास 12, आल्सो यूजफुल फॉर दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु आर अपीयरिंग फॉर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जामिनेशंस लाइक सीईटी, जेईई एंड नीट। लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट फ्यू पॉइंट्स ऑफ अल्कोहल्स। व्हाट एग्जैक्टली अल्कोहल? यू नो, अल्कोहल इज नथिंग बट इट कंटेन्स ए ओएच ग्रुप। Minimum one OH group should be there in the carbon compound. These are the organic compounds actually containing hydroxyl group, OH group. This is called as OH group and can be considered analogues of water. For example, if you take water, so like this, so water is having two lone pair of electrons over oxygen, like this. Why these alcohols are called as analogues of water is nothing but alcohols also contain similar kind of structure, only replacing one hydrogen from water by giving this structure. So, in place of this one hydrogen, we have one alkyl group is present. So, this is actually what we are showing is water structure. This is the general structure of alcohol. So that's why we are calling the alcohols are the analogues of water. Let us see some classification of these alcohols. Classification of alcohols. As you know, some of the alcohols actually not said to contain only one OH group. They may contain two or three alcohol function groups. Such cases we can call they are monohydric. They are monohydric, they are dihydric, they are trihydric alcohols. So in this case, I am going to take an example like methyl alcohol, CH3OH. It is called as CH3OH methyl alcohol. Similarly, I am writing Cu2. H5OH. Also, we have only one OH group is there in this. Dihydric alcohols, you will see here CH2OH, CH2OH is there. So, there are two alcohol hydroxyl groups are there in this alcohol called as dihydric alcohol. Moving on to another one, I am going to write there are three OH groups in this formula. This I can call it as trihydric alcohol. Okay, friends. So, what we understand is nothing but depending on the number of OH groups, we classify alcohols into monohydric alcohols, dihydric alcohols, and trihydric alcohols. Let us see another way of classification. So, in this classification, we are going to tell about primary alcohols. We are telling about secondary alcohols. Secondary alcohols. Another one we are going to tell about tertiary alcohols. Tertiary alcohols. What do you mean by primary? Means here, the carbon should be primary carbon. Means to this carbon there is only one other carbon or alkyl group is attached. Such carbon is linked with a functional group which is there, hydroxyl group, then we will call this is primary alcohol. This is primary alcohol. In other case, secondary case, the carbon should be secondary. Why we are saying it is secondary? Means this carbon is said to link it with the two alkyl groups and which in turn linked with the OH and fourth valency is satisfied by hydrogen. Here also we have two hydrogens are there. Moving on, tertiary carbon. What is mean by tertiary carbon? Tertiary carbon means this carbon is linked with three alkyl groups or carbon atoms in the carbon chain. then this carbon is called as tertiary carbon. If it is linked with the OH hydroxyl group, we will call that is second tertiary alcohol. Okay, I'm going to give an example, that is CH3CH2OH. See, this is called as primary carbon. So this formula is chemical formula is nothing but primary alcohol chemical formula. Come to the secondary alcohol. If you write a OH here, and if this carbon is linked with the two other alkyl groups like methyl groups, then I can call it as a secondary alcohol. So what about the tertiary alcohol? Tertiary alcohol means if we have the carbon linked with the hydroxyl group, which in turn linked with three other alkyl groups like methyl groups, then I can call it as tertiary alcohol. Okay, hope you understand the classification of alcohols into primary, secondary, tertiary alcohols. So this is one way of understanding the classification of alcohols. Okay, let us see now the another important compound in this concept is phenols. Actually, what are phenols? What are alcohols? As we discussed, that alcohols are nothing but they are compounds which contains hydroxyl group in a carbon chain, not the ring. Here, phenols are nothing but these are also hydroxyl groups. If this hydroxyl group is linked with an aromatic ring or benzene ring, then we can call they are phenols. So what are phenols? This is a compound with hydroxyl group bound directly to an aromatic ring or benzene ring are called as phenols. I'll write a benzene ring here. I am going to write a benzene ring. So this is the benzene ring. To this, if you write OH, then you can call it as phenol. Hydroxybenzene is nothing but phenol. Similar fashion, like that of we have classified alcohols into monohydric, dihydric, and trihydric. By that, here also in phenols we can call they are also dihydric, they are also said to be trihydric. How and their classification, we will see. Dihydric phenols and their classification, we will see. Here, I am writing a benzene ring. To that, I am writing two OH groups. This I can call it as catechol. Catechol. In the same way, if this phenol ring, that means benzene ring is there, if that benzene ring is linked with the hydroxyl groups at meta positions, then I can call it as the resorcinol. Resorcinol. I will write C also, don't worry about that. Resorcinol. Similarly, we have this benzene ring at para positions, this OH groups are attached. Then I can call it as quinol. Quinol. So phenols are nothing but hydroxyl group bound directly to an aromatic ring. If there is one OH group is there, that is called as phenol. And this derivatives of phenol, dihydric derivatives of this benzene, we are calling as catechol, resorcinol, quinol, etc. etc. Okay. Let us see nomenclature of alcohols. So to put a particular name to an alcohol, there are different kinds of systems are to be advised in this. A common system is there. In that, we will call these alcohols are nothing but alkyl alkyl alkox. Common system. So that system we will call it as common system. This system we will call it as common system. For example, if you write CH3OH, actually this is CH3 methyl, so this is alcohol, so it is called as methyl alcohol. In the same fashion, if you write the CH2OH, this you can call it as ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol. So, according to the system, what we are doing is alcohols are named as alkyl alcohols. These are nothing but alkyl alcohols. Alkyl alcohols. Moving on to the carbinol system. Carbinol system. What is the another type of system of alcohol classification? Nomenclature is nothing but, in this system, alcohols are regarded as derivatives of methyl alcohol and expressed as carbinol. For example, if we are seeing CH3OH is there, this CH3OH is nothing but carbinol. Carbinol, according to this system. So, what will happen in this case is nothing but, when you are going to write a structure like this, this is called as carbinol. Methyl alcohol is also called as carbinol. And when it comes to ethyl alcohol case, if the carbon is linked with the OH and that carbon in turn with the one methyl group is there, then we will call it as ethyl carbinol. Okay. That we will call it as ethyl alcohol methyl carbinol. So we have, this is methyl is there, so I can call it as methyl carbinol. Understand, this CH3OH is called as carbinol. If this derivative came, then methyl carbinol. What is methyl carbinol? Nothing but, in the case of methyl alcohol, one hydrogen is replaced with alkyl group. If two hydrogens in methyl alcohol is replaced with the methyl group, then how it looks? Let us see. This is CH3, this is CH3. I am writing two methyl groups in place of two hydrogens in methyl alcohol. Then I can call, this is dimethyl carbinol. This is called as dimethyl carbinol. Okay. Let us see the next system, IUPAC system. As you know, what is alkane case is nothing but alkane, alkane. Suppose if you drop this E and if you write ol, then that is called as IUPAC name of this alcohol. Depending on the root name of the alcohols, we can start telling this alcohol's nomenclature. And one more thing, number of carbon, long chain carbon atoms are there, compounds are there, starting at the end, nearest to the OH group, only we will consider their set to be higher priority carbons, and name the remaining substituents and other numbers as alkanes and alkenes. For example, if you write like this carbon system, in this system somewhere I am going to write OH here, and remaining some other places except this place I am writing CH3, here CH3, here I am writing CH3. So here what we understand is nothing but this number of long chain starting. Where is long chain start? Where long chain is starting? And we don't know. So that we can consider by taking this OH attached carbon should be having less number or more priority. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose if I do like this 4, or here 1, 2, 3, 4. It's fine. So you can directly take this straight chain. In this, what will happen? This is the second carbon. This is the third carbon. So on second carbon you have ol is there. On third carbon you have methyl two times repeated. So I can call this is 3, 3 dimethyl. Dimethyl. On second carbon we have ol is there, 2-butanol or but-2-ol. But-2-ol also you can write. So this is one simple example to understand what is the alkane related alcohol. What is alkene related one alcohol we'll see here, that is CH3. Here I am going to write a CH with OH or downwards here. Or CH double bond CH2 I am writing here. So you have to give highest priority to this carbon only, not the double bond. So double bond will be having less priority in this case. So this is third carbon. So third carbon we have ene is there. Second carbon we have ol is there. So you can call it as 2-butene. So last letter E will be removed and we will put this name, that is 2-butene. So 3-butene 2-ol, sorry, 3-butene, this is 3, this is 2-butene 2-ol. We can write it as the name of the compound is 2-butene 3-butene 2-ol. This is another name of the compound. Now I am going to write one example here. One more. Like this. A cyclic compound I am taking, and this OH is present here. Here CH2 CH3 is there. So I can call this one as a cyclic compound, but where this OH attached, this carbon I consider as the first carbon, so I can call it as 1-ethylcyclopropanol. This is called as 1-ethylcyclopropanol. This is, so what we understand is cyclic alcohols have the prefixes cyclo. So cyclopropanol, actual name, but ethyl is there. Okay, that's why you are writing 1-ethylcyclopropanol. So the compounds with the two OH groups are there in this case groups, then they are known as diols. Example, if you start writing number of carbons like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like this we wrote. Somewhere we attached OH groups here and here. Then how can we put name according to IUPAC system? Is that but they are diols. We will start numbering here from here. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is 2. This is 4. So on second carbon, fourth carbon, we have OH groups are there. That's why we will call it as 2, 4 heptane. Last E will be replaced with diol. 2, 4 heptane diol. So this is one case we have. In the case of phenols, the position of four substances are definitely represented with numbers. Not in case of like alcohols, the substance numbers are very important in the case of phenols. Let us see the phenols example in this. Now, so if I write OH here to the benzene ring, here VR I am writing, then the terms ortho, meta, para are also important, okay, in the case of this study of this. But if you write this structure, this in this structure bromine will come first in the alphabetic order. This is called as 2-bromo phenol. So whatever you are telling in the common system as ortho, para, meta, in this ortho bromo phenol, UPAC name is 2-bromo phenol. If the case is quite different, then in the place of Br we are going to change this Br into CH3. Here CH3 I am writing. Here I am writing OH. Then this OH carbon is first carbon and this is third carbon. I will call it as this is 3-methyl phenol. 3-methyl phenol. Actually, the positions are in meta position is there. So meta, methyl, phenol. Methyl phenol, actually it is the common name of this compound. Okay, not only this one, we have several examples are there. Depending on the position, we will write their nomenclature also. Let us see their other different cases of the examples. So now we have three carbons are there, like this here CH3, we have CH2, OH is there. So depending on the position of this OH group, IUPAC name will be given to it. A first carbon it is there, so we will call it as 1-propanol. So if the position of OH group is quite different, then this is CH3, here CH, I am writing OH here, I am writing CH3 here. So on the second carbon we have this OH group is there, then we will call it as 2-propanol. 2-propanol. In the same fashion, if chain is quite different, chain isomerism is there in the discussion we have. Okay, chain isomerism is there. Then how the example will be there? Let us see one more example. We have CH3, CH2, OH here. This is one carbon chain with OH is there. The another thing we have CH3, here I am writing CH3, here I am writing CH2, OH. The difference between these two things you understand, both are actually isomers, the same formula, molecular formula, but their chain is different. This is a straight chain, this is a branched chain. In this case, you can simply call it as 1-butanol. 1-butanol. But in this case, this is first carbon, this is second carbon. Second carbon, we have methyl is there. That we will call it as 2-methyl. This is the parent chain we have. Three carbons are there. That's why we will call it as 1-propanol. This is the name of this compound. Okay. We will see further examples in the next class.